So just what really is the study of statistics? What does this word really mean? The word statistics, meaning the study of, remember we have a statistic, which is something that you're analyzing or something that comes from the sample, and then we have statistics, the study of. So when we talk about the actual study of statistics, a reasonable definition here would be the collection, analysis, and summary. The summary part is extremely important. And presentation of data. It's actually from the Greek word stata. Now, I'm not sure if it's actually pronounced stata or stata or how it's pronounced. I don't speak Greek, but it's from this Greek word stata, which simply means the state of affairs. So when we're actually talking about the study of statistics, we're talking about the study of the state of affairs. I'll say of, I'm going to say something of interest. So if we're doing a political poll, as an example, we want to know the state of affairs of the electorate at that time. You know, what are people thinking? Who are they going to vote for? That's the idea of the study of statistics. Now, the study of statistics is also broken down into two areas. The first one is descriptive statistics. And descriptive statistics simply describes the sample data. So if you go out and take a sample, and from that sample you calculate a sample average, that is a descriptive statistic because it's describing the sample. So if you say, based on my sample, 62% said they're going to vote for candidate whoever, that would be a descriptive statistic. It's describing the sample. Now, the other form is inferential statistics. It's really the inferential statistics that we rely on much more heavily. And what inferential statistics does is it uses the results from the sample data. So, in other words, it takes this descriptive statistic, whatever that value is, and it's used to infer, hence the term inferential statistics. It's used to infer something about the population. So, I want to go back and talk about what's really happening in the population. But I'm going to use this sample to do it. And also, the commonly is often referred to simply as generalizing to the population. Now, here's the idea. Remember up here I said like 62% of the sample said whatever, they're going to vote for whoever. Now, if I take the 62% and I say something like 62% will vote for, you know, candidate X, whoever. What I've done is I've taken this estimate right here from the sample, and I've used that to say, hey, my best estimate is really 62% of the entire population will vote for this candidate. So this is my prediction. I'm inferring what's going to happen with the population based on what I saw with the sample. And that is actually brings us to the whole power, the whole concept behind data analysis. The ability to take a sample, calculate something for it, a sample statistic, and then based on that sample, infer back to the population. That single concept is incredibly important. If you can keep that concept in mind throughout the entire course, you'll be ahead of the game. Because quite often in the semester, we tend to lose sight of what's really going on here. And that's really the bottom line of 99% of what we're trying to do.